Google has released their next flagship model, Gemini 2.5 Pro. Yes, there is no Gemini 2 Ultra and even no Gemini 2.5 Flash. Straight to Gemini 2.5 Pro. They are boldly claiming that this is their most intelligent model. To claim the title of the most intelligent model out there, it has to beat Grok 3 thinking and OpenAI O3 Mini High in reasoning and max, and Claude 3.7 Sonnet in coding. Let's see if that is the case. Is Gemini 2.5 Pro the best model? Let's find out. Let's start off with coding. A head-on competition between Gemini 2.5 Pro and Claude 3.7 Sonnet thinking. So starting off with Sonnet, I asked it to generate a complete 3D interactive solar system where I can go near planets and learn about them. It is a hard task, guys. So as you guys can see, it goes on to write all the files and it's done. Let's see what it has done. Okay, so this is the solar system. If we zoom close to the sun, we can see the info about it. Nice. But we are not able to freely move and the planets are also moving fast. Let's do one thing. Let's first introduce fly mode. So I asked it to add WASD controls so I can freely move. So it goes on and makes the edits. And we have got the response. Let's see, guys. Okay, so now I'm able to move freely, but catching these planets is hard, guys, given they are moving so fast. So let's fix that next. I asked substantially reduce the speed of the planets. So it goes on and make the edits and I think it's done. Let's see. Okay, it has reduced the speed and now we can see Jupiter's information. And that's Saturn, I guess. It doesn't look like one, does it? Okay, now it's time to move on to Gemini 2.5 Pro. Let's select that model and I have sent the prompt. And as you guys can see, it goes on, makes the files and the whole website basically. And it's done. Let's have a look. Okay, so straight up we can see we have all the planets. And unlike Claude Sonnet, Saturn has rings here. So now let's ask it to add the fly mode and also information about the planets, which this is lacking. And I think it's done. Let's have a look. And look at that, guys. We are able to freely move and also it has more degrees of freedom compared to Sonnet. Absolutely awesome. Now you can see me flying past all planets. Isn't that awesome? And we can see the info of the planets as well. That's absolutely awesome. So if we compare the responses, I would say that Gemini was able to give us a better response, which was according to our original prompt of interactive solar system. That's a clear win for Gemini 2.5 Pro. Now let's see, can they draw a dragon in a web page? Okay, so this is what both have generated. We can see that Gemini was accurate to what we asked for, it did the job. And if you look at Claude Sonnet's response, of course, it's the king of aesthetics and it gave a very good looking response. If we just see about fulfilling the task that we asked for, both models get a pass. But comparatively, I would say that Claude is better. Let's ask the models to generate the Super Mario game. What do you think? Who will win? So if you see the result, this is what both the models have generated. You can see again, Gemini gets the job done. It makes a game which works. But aesthetically, there is no comparison because Claude mimics the exact looks of the Super Mario game. So again, it's a pass for both models, but it's a clear win for Claude. Now let's see if they can animate falling letters. So if you see the results, you can see it's a tough competition, guys. If I have to nitpick, I would say that ball's movements were smoother in Gemini. But in Gemini, you can see the letters fall so fast, but suddenly slow down in midair. So I will say that both have their pros and cons and it's a tie between these two models. A tough competition, guys. These models are performing head to head. By the way, if you're liking this comparison, do hit the like button. Next up, can they code a hollow circle with bouncing balls? This is something many models have been getting wrong, guys. So if you compare the responses, again you can see both models get it right and working. And as always, Gemini gets the job done. Although looking simple, it works. Again, if I have to nitpick, you can see the opening is not clearly defined in Claude Sonnet's response. So with that observation, I would say that Gemini is better in this. But it's tough to find who is better, guys. Let's make these models sweat, guys. It's time for some hard question. So in this question, they have to write a Python program that simulates the Earth's rotation. And honestly speaking, both models were not able to give me a working code, guys. And after a lot of back and forth, these were the results. Clearly, no doubt Gemini has the best response. This is the best I've ever gotten. And on the contrary, this is what Claude Sonnet has come up with. So this point goes to Gemini. So now if you look at the results, you can see that it's a close call with Claude being better in two tests and both being front-end. That is the dragon and the Mario game. And Gemini being better in three tests. That is the solar system question, the bouncing balls and Earth's rotation. We can see that Claude is better in aesthetics, but Gemini was better in getting the physics right and just making things work. So, when it comes to coding, Claude was defeated, guys. But let me tell you, our original question, the most intelligent model, that doesn't resolve just with coding, guys. it has to fight with Grok and OpenAI O3 Mini in max and reasoning, and things are not like what we expect. And since we are talking about state-of-the-art models, let's directly jump to very hard reasoning problems, starting off with a 64 tennis player question. So in this question, there is a tournament between 64 players, and we have to say, if player 23 and 46 can play with each other, can anyone from the options can play with each other? And the answer is yes, only 9 and 13 will be able to play with each other. So starting off with Grok, it thinks a lot, guys. But it gets it wrong the first time and the second time. But on the third time, it gets it right. And let me tell you guys, no models other than Grok has been able to get it right even once. So that is a thing to consider. But will that change? Let's see, guys. Let's go to Gemini 2.5. So I send the question to the model and it thinks a lot. And it gets it right, guys. The first time, the second time and the third time. Guys, 3 out of 3 points compared to just 1 from Grok. Absolutely awesome performance. But there is more. Next up is a seating arrangement question. So in this question, 8 friends sit around a square table. But according to some specific conditions, which are mentioned here, you can pause and have a look. So I send this question to Grok, previous best reasoning model, and to Gemini 2.5 Pro. And let me tell you guys, no model has been able to get this right up until this point, in one shot. So if you see Grok's response, it does the usual mistake, guys. It gets the left and right wrong. It puts F in the 4th seat instead of putting it in 2nd seat, which is the actual right hand side of D. That's a fail from Grok. But let's see what Gemini does. And you can see, guys, it gets it right in one shot. It clearly places F in the 2nd seat, that is right of D. Absolutely awesome, guys. No model has been able to get this right in one shot. Absolutely awesome. And you can see the arrangements as well. Absolutely awesome, guys. So Gemini 2.5 Pro absolutely annihilates Grok when it comes to reasoning, and Grok is defeated in reasoning. Now let's move on to the final domain, that is max. Let's see. So since we are comparing state-of-the-art models, let's directly compare them against frontier math. And it's the first time I will test almost all questions that I have in frontier math. So starting off with OpenAI O3 Mini High. So it gave me a lot of intermediary code, and it was a long back and forth between me and the model. But finally, it gave me the correct response. Absolutely awesome. Now it was time for Gemini 2.5 Pro. So I got the code from the model, but I think we don't need to run the code, because have a look at the code. The correct answer is visible right there. It gives us a correct response, guys, without even needing any help. That's absolutely awesome. Next up was a harder level question. Again, I sent it to O3 Mini High, and it took a very long time. So I thought, in the meantime, why not send the question to Gemini 2.5, and for a change, I send it to Grok as well to see how it does. So I got the response from Grok, and I tested it, and it turns out, that's right, guys. You can pause and compare the results. So now I went back to O3 Mini, I ran it and was not able to do that, guys. That's a fail for O3 Mini. Now it was time for Gemini 2.5. And if we look at the code, we can see it gave a wrong answer. So only Grok was able to get it right, guys. So now I sent the next question to O3 Mini High, to Grok, and also to Gemini 2.5. And went back and forth with all of these models. And O3 Mini gave me the code, I ran it, and it gave me a correct answer, guys. That's absolutely awesome. Next up was Gemini 2.5. I got the code, I ran it, and again, Gemini 2.5 got it right. Absolutely awesome. Now it was time for Grok. I got the code, I ran it, and it gave me a wrong response. That's a fail from Grok. Now it was time for the final question. So I sent this first to O3 Mini, then to Gemini 2.5, and finally to Grok. So let's first check O3 Mini's response. I ran the code, and it gave me a wrong answer, guys. Next up was Gemini 2.5. I ran the code, and again, a wrong answer. And finally, Grok. I got the code, I ran it, and again, that was the wrong answer. So the final question, no model was able to solve it. I think this question is for DeepSeek R2 and OpenAI O3. So what are the scores? Even if we exclude the first question where Grok was not involved, in the second question, Grok and Gemini 2.5 gave correct responses. And in question 3, O3 Mini High and Gemini 2.5 gave the correct answer. And the fourth question, no model was able to give us the correct answer. So that is 2 points for Gemini 2.5. 1 point for Grok and 1 point for O3 Mini High. So even in max, Gemini 2.5 scores the best, guys. It has beaten all the current models and is the state of the art, guys. What a comparison it was. So if you like the content, please do hit the like button, subscribe to my channel for more such in-depth videos, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.